is an exciting time to be working in seaweed industry and researching seaweed aquaculture. There's a lot of hype, a lot of excitement around farming seaweed right now. There's multiple ways in which this industry can grow and to scale up. It's important to understand how these seaweed farms contribute to restorative aquaculture in our coastal environments.
The idea is to try and understand whether there's some fundamental ecological principles that apply globally and not just in New Zealand or not just in Maine. So by doing a parallel research methods and finding identical results or similar results of the patterns of ecological changes that we see associated with the seaweed farming, then in a sense we can infer it that it's likely to happen in other parts of the world where seaweed farms is developed.
We set out with the goal of trying to understand if seaweed farms provide habitat to wild organisms, in particular fish that might be swimming around in the area, or benthic invertebrates like lobsters, crabs. Both wild seaweed beds and seaweed aquaculture do provide very valuable services and potentially habitat to organisms. The research that I conduct in my lab with my students is heavily motivated by industry members. That's how we decide what research to do.
So when we first started farming seaweed alongside of our mussels, we had a hunch that that seaweed was actually going to help our mussels, our shellfish, also grow better because of the way that the seaweed sucks nutrients out of the water, carbon out of the water. A few years later, we actually had that confirmed by working with various research organizations. They showed significantly that mussels grown within a seaweed farm or near a seaweed farm actually grow faster, better, and bigger.
While you're growing seaweed during that season, from November to about May, that creates a habitat for marine animals as well. We're seeing a continuous uptick in terms of consumer interest in seaweed, but a lot of that is an education process. As people realize, seaweed is not only good for the environment and the oceans, it's also extremely healthy. It's one of the most nutritionally dense foods on the planet.
I think in the next 10 years, the aquaculture industry will continue to grow. We've always been, and we started farming mussels and kelp because it was environmentally sustainable. Now we've reached a part where the business is sustainable as well.
Besides the ecological impact of seaweed, it really has a strong social impact too. And so we're trying to create as much employment as we can, not only on the water, but also in processing and soon to be more tech-related jobs.
Well, I think here in Coromandel, where there's been some struggles with mussel farming, there's an opportunity for participants in that industry to pivot and to lend their hand to cultivating seaweeds. So I think that's a real opportunity that we're seeing here in this particular area, and I'd say that that would be reflected around New Zealand as well.
The industry has a long way to grow in the next 10 years, and I'm very hopeful for it. Seaweed aquaculture here in Maine is hope for a more resilient and diversified future on a coast where we've always made our livings working on the water. We want to continue to do so.